stupidity.
You need to talk about your TPA.
Sometimes in Microsoft Word, you've created a work of art. You don't just want anyone off the street coming in and making changes to your text equivalent of a Picasso, your Mona Lisa, circa 2017. Today, I'll show you how to edit permissions in a Microsoft Word document. These instructions will work for Microsoft Word 2016 and 2013. First, open the Microsoft Word document for which you want to edit permissions. Click the Review tab in the main navigation menu. Click the Restrict Editing button under the Protect grouping. Note, you can skip the formatting restrictions step if you plan to leave your document as No Changes, Read Only under Editing Restrictions. Otherwise, carry on. To prevent reformatting of your document, check the Limit Formatting to a Selection of Styles under the Formatting Restrictions header. Then click the Settings link to bring up the Formatting Restrictions window. Check the Limit Formatting to a Selection of Style box, and then use the controls to determine what style elements you want to allow in your document. You can choose All, Recommended Minimum, None, or any other custom combination you choose by checking or unchecking the box next to a style or styles. If you'd like to let Word's annoying auto-format feature override formatting restrictions, check the box next to Allow Auto-Format to Override Formatting Restrictions. To disallow changing the document theme or scheme, check the Block Theme or Scheme Switching box. Block Style Set Switching by checking the Block Quick Style Set Switching. Click OK when you're satisfied with the restrictions, or cancel to discard any changes you've made. To allow only certain types of editing in your document, check the Allow Only This Type of Editing in the Document checkbox under the Editing Restrictions header. Select the type of editing you want to allow from the drop-down menu. No Changes, Read Only, Tracked Changes, Comments, or Filling in Forms. To allow certain parts of your document to be freely edited while maintaining restrictions in all other areas, highlight a part of your document where you'd like to allow editing. Then, check the box next to Everyone under Exceptions. People will then be able to freely edit this part of your document. You can repeat this feature multiple times throughout your document by simply selecting an area to allow editing and then checking the Everyone box again under Exceptions. To allow these editing exceptions to only certain people, check the More Users link and enter the email addresses of those you want to give permission to. Be sure to leave the Everyone box unchecked if you only want specific people to have editing permissions. When you're done, click the Yes, Start Enforcing Protection button under Start Enforcement. Under Protection Method, enter and confirm your password in the provided boxes. Click OK when you're done. That's it. Your document is now restricted from the types of editing you have chosen. To disable the restrictions, click the Stop Protection button at the bottom of the pane and enter your password to remove the document protection. You've got the lock and key, and no one is going to besmirch your good work today. That's it for today. If you found this video useful, please share it with others. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Hey, Rachel, can you take this?
Didn't you get the memo?